Hi everyone, my name is David Na and I'm a third year medical student at the University of Maryland School of Medicine. In this presentation, I will talk about the differential diagnoses of leukochoria. First, let's define leukochoria. Leukochoria describes an abnormal white pupillary reflex when we shine light into the pupil. Normally, shining light into the eye should produce a red pupillary reflex as seen in the left picture. This is because the retina appears red in color due to the vascular layer underneath. Therefore, when we see a white reflex, this warrants further investigation. So what are the causes of leukochoria? The most important diagnosis we want to differentiate is retinoblastoma, a type of cancer. The next few are Coase disease, persistent fetal vasculature, and cataracts. These four are the most common causes of the abnormal white reflex. Other less common causes include familial exudated vitro retinopathy, retinal detachment, retinopathy of prematurity, astrocytic hematoma, endogenous endophthalmitis, and pseudoleukocoria. For the rest of this presentation, I will talk about important clinical features of each of these bullet points. Let's first talk about retinoblastoma, the diagnosis we are most concerned about. Retinoblastoma is the most common intraocular malignancy in children and accounts for about 6% of all cancers in those that are less than 5 years old. It is most commonly caused by a genetic mutation in RB1, a tumor suppressor gene involved in the cell cycle. The picture to the right is a fundus photograph showing a white-colored mass growing from the retina consistent with retinoblastoma. Because retinoblastoma is a white-colored mass, if the shine light is in line with the tumor, then you can expect the pupillary reflex to appear white as seen in this patient. Next, let's talk about Coase disease. Coase disease is characterized by the progressive development of abnormal retinal blood vessels and cholesterol exudates. While retinoblastoma presents with leukochoria, Coase disease classically presents with the yellow reflex due to the exudates known as xanthochoria. The exudates can eventually thicken the retina, ultimately resulting in a massive retinal detachment. Coase disease typically presents only in one eye. Next, persistent fetal vasculature. This is a congenital defect that results when the fetal vasculature fails to regress in the eye. The classical presentation includes a cataract, an abnormally small eye known as microphthalmia, and leukochoria in the smaller eye that presents at about 1 to 2 weeks from birth. Next is cataracts. Cataracts describe the clouding of the lens in the eye. While cataracts are a much more common finding in elderly patients, cataracts in a pediatric patient requires additional workup. Congenital cataracts can be caused by certain systemic and genetic etiologies as well as infectious etiologies as listed on this slide. If a child presents with congenital cataracts, it is important for the cataract to be removed at the earliest possible age for the patient to develop good visual acuity later in life. Another type of cataract that may be seen are traumatic cataracts. This can arise from blunt or penetrating trauma, electrical or chemical trauma, and also from radiation. In the picture to the left, you can see the cloudiness in the lens. Familial exudated vitreo retinopathy. This is an inherited disease that is characterized by incomplete vascularization of the peripheral retina, resulting in retinal ischemia. This leads to abnormal retinal angiogenesis and results in traction, exudation, and retinal detachment. The top photo shows an avascular peripheral retina on fluorescein angiography, and the bottom photo shows retinal detachment due to traction. Retinal detachment. This is a serious condition where the retinal layer in the back of the eye detaches from the vascular layer. There are many different causes of retinal detachments. In the pediatric population, the common causes include trauma, abuse, Coase disease, and retinopathy of prematurity. This is a picture of a retinal detachment caused by a tear in the retina. With retinal detachment, the thin layer of the retina can obstruct the light to the vascular layer, giving it a white appearance. In retinopathy of prematurity, as the name suggests, occurs in prematurely born babies. It is associated with the development of abnormal blood vessels in the retina that can progress to retinal detachment in severe cases. In the photograph to the left, you can see a retinal detachment along with proliferation of abnormal blood vessels throughout the retina. Retinal astrocytic hematoma is another ocular tumor that can cause leukocoria. This is a rare glial tumor associated with tuberous sclerosis and neurofibromatosis. On the fundus photograph to the right, you can see the astrocytic hematoma overlying the optic disc. If the shine light is in line with the tumor, then you would expect the pupillary reflex to be white. Endogenous endophthalmitis is a very serious condition that occurs when an infectious agent travels through the bloodstream to the eye. As the immune system fights the infection, inflammatory cells and debris can cloud the vitreous as seen in the photograph to the left. Endogenous endophthalmitis rarely occurs in children. It is more associated with adults with immunodeficiencies and IV drug users. However, one notable infectious agent that can be seen in children is a parasitic worm, Toxocara. This can be found in the feces of puppies and is thought to be a main source of contamination. The parasite travels through the bloodstream through the retina once it is ingested. Characteristic findings include eye pain, floaters, posterior pole granuloma as seen in the top photograph, and vitreous inflammation as seen in the bottom photograph. Leukocoria occurs in 25% of cases and indicates late-stage disease. Lastly, pseudoleukocoria. Pseudoleukocoria refers to a transient leukocoria that is caused by the reflection of a normal optic disc. This can occur in angle photography, where the subject in the photo looks approximately 15 degrees off-axis nasally to bring the normal optic disc in view. Pseudoleukocoria can also be seen in patients with strabismus. Strabismus, or more commonly known as cross eye, is when there is misalignment of the eyes. This occurs in about 4% of children. Due to the misalignment of the eyes, the optic disc shadow can fill the pupil at a certain angle, producing a white reflex. To summarize, there are many different causes of leukocoria. Evaluation for leukocoria should be performed by the primary care physician at routine visits. Newly discovered leukocoria should warrant an urgent referral to an ophthalmologist within 1 week in order to exclude retinoblastoma and other life or sight-threatening conditions. History taking and physical examination in the setting of leukocoria are very important, as it can help point towards a diagnosis. History taking should include prenatal exposures, birth history, medical history, ocular history, and recent environmental exposures. This concludes the presentation of the differential diagnoses of leukocoria. Thank you for listening.